Thank you for choosing the MNUIS from Automation Products Group for your sensor needs. The MNUIS is the result of extensive research into Modbus utility, intrinsic safety, and customer needs, and APG is proud to present the perfect sensor for your application. The MNUIS is CSA and ATEX certified and is even available with optional lightning protection. In this video, we will show many of the basic functions of the sensor and how to set it up for your application. To begin, check out our instructional video on APG Modbus for help hooking up your sensor and setting up communication. Once you have successful communication with your sensor, we can begin at the top of the parameters list. The units parameter sets the unit of measurement the sensor will use to display readings if set in distance mode. Application types 0, 1, and 7 are calculated in distance mode. The application type determines how the sensor will calculate readings. If type 0, 1, or 7 are selected, the readings will be calculated using distance mode. If type 2 through 6, or 9 through 11 are used, the readings will be calculated in volume mode. The volume unit parameter sets the unit of measurement the sensor will use to display readings if set in volume mode. Application types 2 through 6 and 9 through 11 are calculated in volume mode. The decimal place parameter determines how the reading from the sensor will be rounded. For instance, if the sensor reads 1.293 meters and the decimal place is set to 0, 1 meter will be displayed. If the decimal place is set to 3, the full value of 1.293 will be displayed. The max distance parameter determines the distance at which the sensor will no longer accept readings. The sum of the max distance and the offset cannot exceed the maximum operating range of the sensor. The full and empty distance parameters are designed for monitoring tank levels and set the distances from the sensor zero point that the vessel is considered full or empty. The full distance parameter must be set to a distance from the zero point that is equal to or greater than the blinking distance. The empty distance must be less than the max distance for the sensor to accept readings when the vessel is empty. Sensitivity sets the level of gain applied to the sensor signal. In auto sense, hard target, or soft target modes, the parameter sets an upper limit to the gain that can be applied. If the sensor is operated in manual mode, this value will set the gain value. If using manual mode, it is recommended to determine the minimum gain value that will allow the target to be reliably tracked through the full range of expected conditions. This will save power and extend the life of the sensor. The pulses parameter sets the number of ultrasonic pulses per transmission. More pulses will result in a stronger echo being returned to the sensor. In auto sense, hard target, or soft target modes, this parameter will set the maximum pulses allowed to be sent. In manual mode, this value will set the number of pulses. Increasing pulses will create stronger signals in damping environments. In acoustically active environments or enclosed areas, the amount of pulses can be decreased to reduce multiple echoes. Blinking distance is the distance from the zero point of the sensor from which the first echo will be accepted. Blinking distance is commonly used to reduce noise in installations involving a standpipe. It can also be used to ignore unwanted targets between the sensor and the closest target level. As pulse settings are increased, it may be necessary to increase the blinking distance to reduce multiple echoes. Gain control allows you to choose between programming the sensor gain settings manually or allowing the sensor to automatically adjust to optimize its signal. If the sensor is in auto sense, sensitivity and pulses will be determined and optimized by the sensor with no user input. In hard target or soft target mode, the sensor will determine the best settings using the entered sensitivity and pulses parameters as limits. In manual mode, all changes to parameters must be made by the user. Averaging, filter window, out of range, and sample rate parameters work together to stabilize the readings from the sensor. Averaging sets the number of received signals to calculate for the displayed reading. The filter window determines the difference allowed between the current reading and received signals for a signal to be qualified and accepted into the averaging buffer. The out-of-range parameter sets the number of consecutive samples outside the filter window that must be received before the sensor will adjust to the new reading. These parameters can be used to prevent false positives from momentary obstructions, such as waves in a tank application, or objects moving past the sensor area. Sample rate sets the delay time between sensor samples. A shorter sample rate delay results in quicker response times. A longer delay will reduce likelihood of false positives and prolong sensor life. Here we have a sensor set up reading around 1.4 meters. With the sensor programmed with default settings, we can see that the sensor is averaging 10 readings to determine the displayed value. The filter window is set so that any readings more than 50 millimeters different from the current reading will not be accepted into the averaging buffer, and will instead read into the out-of-range buffer. The out-of-range value determines that 10 readings outside of the filter window must be received before the new readings will begin to be received into the averaging buffer. With these settings, it takes approximately 3 seconds for the sensor to respond to a new target. If we want to increase the rate of sensor response, we can lower the averaging rate and out-of-range samples. Now the sensor is calculating the readings faster and waiting less time before accepting the new out-of-range readings. The result is a response time of around 1 second or less to the new target. This could be further refined by changing filter window, increasing or decreasing the distance a new target must be from the original before engaging the out-of-range buffer. Conversely, if we increase the averaging and out-of-range readings, the sensor will be less prone to catching unwanted targets, such as passerbys or waves, in a tank application. With averaging and out-of-range values set to 20, the sensor takes around 5 seconds to respond to the same target. These settings can be adjusted and fine-tuned to the specifics of your sensor environment. The multiplier parameter is used to adjust for changes in the speed of sound due to atmospheric variations. To calibrate this, aim the sensor at a known target that is near the maximum range distance of the sensor. Adjust the multiplier value until the distance displayed by the sensor matches the known distance to the target. Offset sets the point from which calculated distance will be measured. If the offset is set to 0, this point is the transducer face. Changing the offset positive moves the 0 point away from the transducer and towards the target. Moving the offset negative moves the 0 point behind the sensor face. Blanking is measured from the end of the offset. Temperature compensation automatically adjusts the multiplier to compensate for temperature effect on readings. QuickMode sets the number of samples to average for a quick distance reading. The QuickMode delay specifies the length of delay in milliseconds between power on and the quick distance reading being taken. Power up takes 250 milliseconds, which should be accounted for in calculating delay time. For instance, to delay the quick reading by 1/2 second, or 500 milliseconds, after completion of power up, the quick mode delay should be set to 750. To use a sensor in quick mode, it is important to first make sure that all sensor settings have been optimized for your application. This includes adjusting blanking and other distance settings to match the environment. Sensitivity and pulses should be adjusted to the lowest setting that can still read the full expected range of the sensor in all expected environmental conditions. To initiate quick mode, write the number of samples desired to the quick mode enable parameter. The sensor will quickly read the number of samples you entered and then enter a low power mode. The average of the readings taken will be displayed, and individual readings can be viewed by clicking the MNUIS Quick Mode Reset menu option under the Tools tab. To trigger another Quick Mode sample, you can either change the number of samples in register 40421, write a non-zero value to holding register 40187, or power cycle the sensor. Pulse power functions as a secondary gain control and sets the percentage of power to use for each transmission. This gain is independent of gain control and so will not be affected by autosense. The quick mode resample holding register will trigger a quick mode sample from a sensor in waiting status whenever a value other than 0 is written to holding register 40187. A resample can also be triggered by changing the quick mode samples or power cycling the sensor. If you need to reset your MNUIS to factory settings, select the Reset to MNUIS Defaults menu option under the Tools tab. Trip value, window, and type can be configured to create outputs in input registers 30309 through 30310. These are not electrical or mechanical triggers and so will not generate their own alarms. When interfaced by a web-enabled master controller with the Level and Flow website or another RS-485 interface, the interface can be set up to trigger alarms from these input registers. If you have any problems setting up your MNUIS, please contact our application engineers for assistance. If you are interested in setting up your sensor in APG's Tank Cloud, featuring 24/7 remote monitoring with alarms sent straight to your device, please contact us at 877-373-5940 or on our website at www.apgsensors.com.